Do you find yourself constantly browsing through samples without finding what you're looking for? This is something most producers can relate to. You just can't seem to find that one sample you know would work. Today, I'm going to show you a simple workflow trick that will save you a lot of time. So keep on watching, and I'll show you how to do it right after this.
This is a Firewalk production.
Over the years, producers tend to buy one sample pack after the other, each containing hundreds if not thousands of samples. Eventually, it becomes impossible to keep track of everything. How many hours have you spent looking for that one snare, clap, or whatever it is that you know would work because you've used it before, but you just can't seem to find it? The solution to this problem is quite simple. Organization. One of the reasons established producers tend to work so fast is because they work smart. They have organized all their samples, presets, etc. in such a way that they can quickly find exactly what they are looking for. You may also have noticed that many producers tend to use some of the same samples in many of their tracks. The Neptune Project, for example. They use the same kick drum in just about all their tracks. They call it the Neptune Kick. It's part of their unique sound. And then there's Kygo, who also reuses a lot of the same samples in his tracks. What all these artists have in common is that they have found sounds that they know will work well in a track, and therefore they tend to stick with them. Before we continue, let's make it perfectly clear, I'm not saying that you should use the same exact samples in all of your tracks. If you do that, then all of your tracks will sound very similar and people will eventually grow tired of your music. It's okay to reuse a few sounds, though, as part of your own unique sound, but try not to use the same exact combination of sounds every time. This is what you should be doing. When you find a sample you really like, you should save it in a favorites folder. Eventually, you'll have a huge collection of really good samples that you know will work. If you're looking for a real good clap, for example, you can just go to your favorites folder and instantly have all your favorite claps at your disposal. I encourage you to try and be creative and use new samples most of the time, of course. However, if you find yourself in a situation where you're just browsing through samples without finding anything, you can always go to your favorites folder and choose something that you know will work. This saves a lot of time. You'll always have some really good go-to samples at your disposal. That way you won't be stuck in cases where you can't seem to find anything to use. So let's get started. There are many ways to do this, but I'll show you how I usually do it. The first thing you have to do is make a favorites folder. So let's go ahead and create a new folder. Let's call it My Favorites. It's a good idea to keep this folder organized with dedicated subcategories. So I'll go ahead and create a few folders. Make sure you keep your favorites folder open in the background. Next, open up the FL Studio browser and start browsing. When you find a sample you really like, right-click on it, select Windows Shell Menu, and then Copy. Then go to the My Favorites folder we just created. Since this is a kick, we'll want to have it in the Kicks folder. Then just right-click and select Paste. The sample will then be copied into that folder. You can do this for all your favorite samples, kicks, claps, hats, and so on. If you keep doing this, eventually you'll have a huge collection of really good samples readily available. The last step is to make the favorite folder easily accessible from the FL Studio browser. To do that, go to Options, File, and then click here to select your favorite folder. Now when you open the browser, your favorite folder will show up in it. Now you can easily browse through all of your saved favorites. If it does not show up right away, you may have to manually refresh it by clicking here. Just remember, whenever you stumble upon a really good sample from now on, always copy it to your favorites folder. That's it! I'm uploading new tutorials and templates every week, so make sure to subscribe to this channel so that you won't miss out. I hope this was helpful. If you liked the video, please like, share, and comment. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more tutorials.